the Euros was a game-changing moment for women's football, and since then, obviously, it's really kicked on in terms of the crowd attendances in the WSL this season, the interest in the women who play the game, and, you know, I just see it on my Instagram feed, you know, them kind of doing all kinds of interesting advertising campaigns and being involved in, you know, really good brand associations. And now those things are really important because it means that they are kind of powerful and influential women in society, and that's what we wanted. You know, we wanted people to look up to them as role models, look up to them as great sportswomen, and for them to reap the rewards for that. It's brilliant.
And in terms of those rewards, I think obviously, perhaps more so than almost any other sport, women's football has been a sort of a lightning rod for the debate surrounding equal pay. And I think obviously the growth in attendance might actually help facilitate that. Can you talk a little bit about how you feel about that issue? Because obviously it's a complicated one.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, there's been, there is a disparity between what men and the women earn. There's a disparity between what their contracts, you know, the TV contracts are worth. There's a disparity between what the crowds are. And that's moving in the right direction. That's all we can kind of, I think, ask for, is to keep that growth going and get to a stage where, you know, there is parity. You know, you look at sports where there is more parity, in golf and tennis, where, you know, you get equal pay. And that's because they're played, obviously, usually in those big championships, they're on the same stage. And so I suppose we've got to kind of like keep pushing for those audiences, keep asking people to enjoy the sport, which is brilliant. And, you know, we'll get there.